Welcome to the Coalition server. We are in the middle of a beautiful cherry blossom grove here, as you can plainly see. Let me get into the thing here. Beautiful cherry blossom grove. We are playing on the Direwolf 20 Feed the Beast mod pack for 1.6.4. And we are all playing with biomes aplenty. So we get beautiful places like this. And slime islands up in the skies like that. That one's a good one. You could actually probably swim up that water trough and get to it. But no, we are at spawn. This is the spawn hut that Lapis Lori built. Surprised it's not blue. But we are going to head off in that direction. I'm going to spare you some of the boring details here of, gathering materials and traveling and such as that. I went into a creative test world here and found myself a place to live. So I'm going to venture over that way when it's daytime again, because all I got's a wooden sword and, like, random crap. I got some potatoes and some carrots to take with me and plant once I get over there. And then we're going to get to work, and we're going to feed this beast. So, I'll see you in a bit. Hey, everybody, and welcome to my beautiful dead forest. This place is amazing. It's got a village to work with. Yeah. And there's little girls running around in the background with barely nothing on. I'm kind of digging that. Big old volcano. Yep. And farms aplenty. And people's to trade with. This is my spot. Yeah, this is my spot. Okay, it's not really my spot. This is, if you look on the little mini map in the top corner of the screen there, beautiful dead forest on the creative world that I looked around, flew around, ooh, made it. And I was like, oh, this place is perfect. I have got to check this place out. Look at some of these trades on some of these villagers. These are cool. Like I can use a tool station and a landmine, and I can get some copper, goofy, feed the beast kind of trades. I saw this place, and I'm like, oh, this is absolutely perfect. I definitely want to live here. It was like a temple. And then I went into the real world. Dun, dun, dun. And then I go into the real world, and this is what I get. The village is still here. It's mostly the same. But it's in a stupid taiga biome. It's not what I wanted at all! There is something funky going on with degeneration. You can see on the minimap. Everything's the same, other than the fact that I am in a taiga, and it's supposed to be dead forest. There is a spot, where is it? Straight up that way. If you look at the very top corner of the map, you can see the little square. There's some funky terrain generation going on between when the world was created and when chunks were rendered and loaded. So, there's like chunk errors like that. And things, biomes changed, and it's just real goofy. But let me show you my setup here. I've got my smeltery going on here, which reminds me I need to finish making this axe, or this hammer. I have been taking so long to make these. Oh, don't tell me there ain't enough in there. Don't tell me there ain't enough in there, you stupid. Oh, there was 8 ingots in there, and that thing costs 8. Okay, fine. I'll fix that later. But I made myself a pretty pink axe, which is a beast, and a pickaxe, which is a beast. Reinforced them with some redstone. That makes them go faster. Speed mining and such. And I've got just a little setup here. A crystal chest. These things are stupid expensive, but they're worth it because they hold just a crap ton of stuff. That's like, what, 6 double chests, I want to say, is what goes in that one. There's like 4 double chests and a gold one. And then an iron chest, which is the step below, is just a double chest. So you take iron, or you take a regular chest, and then you circle it in your crafting interface with iron. Like, boop, 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 around there. And then if you want to make a gold chest, you put your iron chest here and then surround it with gold. And then they got a diamond chest, which you do. And then you take the diamond chest finally and you encase it in glass to get this crystal here. But like I say, it's crazy expensive, but worth it. Oh wait, no, this is not 8 diamonds. It's like 4, to keep the cost down. But I also have a little bit of a power supply here. We've got an aqueous accumulator, and what that does is if you put it down in between source blocks like this, it's just like taking a bucket and digging out the middle one. You'll always have water there. It creates an infinite source. Well, this takes that infinite water and puts it into the steam dynamo, which is at the moment fired by coal and charcoal. And then that goes down and it goes into my redstone furnace and my pulverizer, which, the pulverizer is what they call ore doubling. And what that'll do is if you put like one piece of like iron ore in it, it will break that down into 2 pieces of dust. And then those 2 pieces of dust become 2 ingots. So you get basically double your production. It doesn't work with everything, but it works with most. Yeah, and then I've got, another portal over there and a farm. Let's see here. I can kind of take you over there. Yeah, here's my farms. I got some carrots and some potatoes, and then I got some reeds down there. And I have a place here where I chop down trees to get my wood for my charcoal and wood for other wooden things. And then I've got, which one is it? I think it's this one. Yeah. I don't need this anymore because damn zombie got the villager that was in here. So he came through the roof. Hey, old Minecraft's here. I'd say hi, but I'm recording. But I've got all my woods in here, and I've been just kind of flying around trying to find different cool saplings. Oh, I need to put this guy up in here. There we go. And yeah, flying around because I can do that. Hello. Let's say hi. And let's tell him we're recording. And yeah, so we got this cool function on Feed the Beast here. It's called morph. And let me show you. I can turn into any of the things that I have killed. And I recently just got a bat. So. I'm a bat. And I can fly around. Yes. Now I'm not gonna do that voice. But yeah, I can still like mine and place and pick up things, but I could fly around. And let me actually take you over here and show you that chunk error thingy that I was talking about. And this is a really helpful mod. Like if you want to go dig in clay at the bottom of the ocean, you can just turn into a squid and breathe underwater. It's awesome. Oh, frames. There we go. Yeah, see here it is. This you can tell this was a straight up chunking error. Look at that flat walls on this Daily Whomper here. Yeah, this was all supposed to be dead forest as far as the eye could see, and it isn't. So, ooh, what was that? Nothing. Okay. But the volcano is still there. Well, sort of, kinda. If it'll ever load in. Here, let me The F3 and A thing still works, which is kind of nice. Well, supposed to. Probably because I'm recording. It's generating at a little lower rate. Yeah, the lava is starting to dissipate. And this thing, I'm not sure how full it is. I want to think that it goes all the way to the bottom. But this is where I come and I get my lava buckets for my furnace over here. My smeltery, if you will. So. Yeah, I've got a bunch of random crap over at this base here, and since it's not the dead forest that I was really kind of hoping for, ooh, there's some iron gravel. I'll have to come back for that. Since it's not the one I was hoping for, what are you? Oh, nothing. Okay. I'm going to fly around until I find a new place to live, and then I'm going to cart up all of my crap and take off wherever I'm gonna go. Another thing about it is the neighbors are really, really close. Let's see here. Spawn is just Not too far away, over here. Yeah, here's that cherry blossom grove that we started in. And if it ever loads in, you'll see. Yep, there's spawn. Okay. And if we go in this direction a little bit, oh, there's a black thing. What's a black thing? Is it chunk air? Let's let this load in for a second here. That's a good thing about being able to fly around. You can see all kinds of good stuff. Oh, no, that's just a spooky, ominous woods. It's another biome type. And I'll tell you, the flying really takes it out of you guys. Come on, let's do this again. He'll load in. But like I say, this is a great way to fly around and get trees and stuff. Ooh, I need lily pads. Hang on here. Swimming bat. What's up, chicken? Ooh, chicken trying to get with me. Get off me. Okay. And yeah, Drax is over in this direction. This is Drax's place. And I'm not going to show what he's doing there. But I did have eyes on this mountain at one time. And then I realized that was the mountain he was in. So, and look how close he is to me. It's like, bang. Not that I don't like my buddies and my friends, but they're just a little too close. You're not gonna keep them neighbors at bay. Otherwise, they'll be over at your house trying to borrow a cup of Tanzanite, or, hey, brother, can you spare a stack of coal, or stuff like that. Not that I don't mind. I love helping people out. I'm just joking with you. But no, it's just a little too close for comfort, and everybody's like really concentrated here at spawn. So, just kind of a quickie little update video for all of you all. Whoop. Just a little update video for all of you all to whoop. There we go. See what I've been up to the last few days, and when you see me next time, hopefully I will have a different hat. And as the sun sets, I think I will see you guys next time. I'm gonna search high and low and low and high for a new base to call my home. And I will see you all next time. Peace.